One of the islands along the northern coast of New Guinea, named Wakde, W-A-K-D-E, was rather small. It was so small that the only area suitable for an airstrip was not quite a mile, which is very short for a fully loaded four-engine bomber, and carrying maximum capacity. And on one of my trips down to get more replacement crews, I was lucky I got four crews and brought them back with me in my plane, my C-47. And we're doing a lot of talking and everything, and there's a long mission going to take place the next day for which we had been preparing. It would be the longest mission of a four-engine bomber that had ever been made yet against the Japanese oil wells and refineries, oil refineries in Borneo area. And to lighten the planes and make it easier to get them off the ground, we even sandblasted all the paint off the outside of every plane. Believe it or not, that took about 400 pounds of weight off each plane. Everything we could do. And we had to replace that in order to have enough fuel for the bomb run. For the first time, we put wingtip tanks out on the ends of the wings with controls that the pilot could control. To switch over to those planes, those wingtip tanks. Maybe they used them first and then dropped them off. I don't know, whatever. Anyway, I have these four crews that I brought back from New Guinea, and I told them the flight's going to take off tomorrow, maximum effort, before light, even. And because we want them back and landing before dark. So we want to go out and attend the takeoff. And we'd like to watch that flight take off. Now they'd been trained as pilots, navigators, bombardiers, you know, the 11-man crews, because there are radar operators among them too. And they had gone through the replacement training center down in Najab, the middle of New Guinea, in the course of which they had made some what are called milk runs, not dangerous ones where they'd be shot at, but they would make bomb runs against Japanese targets. And that was their training now in preparation for actually going to war, finally. And they want to go down and watch this takeoff. I was so sorry afterwards that I had given permission. I liked to do that myself, both takeoff and landings. But the unfortunate thing, out of the 37 planes that were in good condition to make that long a flight, four of them never got off the ground. The runway was too short. It should have been another, say, 500 feet longer. They started off at the edge of the water at the beginning, had their planes, had their engines roaring, took off the brakes and achieved maximum speed as fast as they could, get to the other end of the runway, and just barely make it up into the air. And four of them didn't make it. Instead, they landed on the coral rocks offshore, blew up, killed everybody aboard. Can you imagine what an introduction that was to combat for those four replacement crews? I think they must have been white in the face.